Following the violence in DC yesterday, some in the Trump administration are no longer in the Trump administration, and others are criticizing Trump's complete lack of response. And before we get into this, and we can debate how much, if any, credit any of these individuals get, as of right now, we had yesterday Trump put out like three different statements, like a couple of tweets that ended up having to literally be taken down. The first time I've ever seen Twitter actually take down his tweets. He was then suspended as a result of that. He then put out a video telling the terrorists that he loves them and they're very special people. And then that has effectively been it. The president had been radio silent since then. After the Capitol was looted, he didn't have anything to say. So here is what we've got. Trump officials resigning include Matt Pottinger, the deputy national security advisor, Stephanie Grisham, chief of staff to First Lady Melania Trump, Sarah Matthews, the deputy press secretary, Ricky Nassetta, White House social secretary, Mick Mulvaney, actually, former White House chief of staff, Mick Mulvaney has resigned, and Ryan Tully, senior director for European and Russian affairs at the National Security Council. They have now resigned, as well as apparently Tyler Goodspeed, the acting chair of the White House Council of Economic Advisors. And we have heard that Steven Mnuchin is not. So some are stepping down, although again, remember, the administration is gone bye-bye in 2 weeks. So Rashad, how much credit do they get?
Who the F cares that they resign? 13 days left. And I promise you, these guys would not have resigned if he had a year left, 2 years left. So they can miss me with it. They resigned because the job is almost over anyway. This is a way for them to save a little political face or attempt to. The public relations nightmare has gone out of control. But this is the pure definition of chickens coming home to roost. You sent these chickens out. We didn't send these chickens out, you did. And we've been telling you for years, these are the chickens you're sending out. And now they have come home to roost and they're roosting on your front porch.
I saw a tweet to the effect of, oh my God, the monster turned on its creator. Is there any precedent for this in film or TV? Or like, yeah, this is like, we're gonna get to some headlines and stuff. It's just, it's so much of this just feels in hindsight like, yeah, I guess this was exactly how it had to be. I guess this was the only way it could have been. Anyway, we do have other people leaving the Trump administration, although not resigning, interestingly. Chad Wolf, the acting secretary of Homeland Security, put out this statement this morning. What transpired, and this is, by the way, this is a guy who has defended Trump a ton, defended his immigration policy and all that. He said, what transpired yesterday was tragic and sickening. While I have consistently condemned political violence on both sides of the aisle, we now see some supporters of the president using violence as a means to achieve political ends. This is unacceptable. These violent actions are unconscionable, and I implore the president and all elected officials to strongly condemn the violence that took place yesterday. I will remain in my position until the end of the administration to ensure the department's focus remains on the serious threats facing our country and an orderly transition to President-elect Biden's DHS team. So there, he is saying that these are Trump supporters, they're not Antifa, and Trump needs to condemn them. Well, Trump has responded to that call by withdrawing Chad Wolf's nomination to be the permanent Homeland Security Secretary. He had just been acting, and Trump responded to that by effectively removing him from his position. So he didn't say anything, but I feel like we got the message, Rashad.
Yeah, absolutely. And this goes back to the reality of who Trump is, number one, and the reality of who we are as a country. Trump did not do this by himself. Yes, he has a wrecking ball leadership style. Yes, he's an extremist. Yes, he is in fact the radical. But he also had such significant support with a large demographic, a large population of Americans. He was able to get away with it. And there was a time when Republicans could have saved and salvaged the democracy. It's right now in shambles, and I would predict you're not gonna get a Republican president in our lifetime again. Just not gonna happen. That's my prediction today. They will obviously continue to fight and continue to be competitive, but you gotta watch out now for Trump coming back without being president. And the question is he more dangerous or less dangerous? I say more dangerous because he has zero restriction at that point in what he will say and what he's willing to endorse and promote.
Yeah, I mean, look, hypothetically, he also has less protection from legal consequences.
Correct.
Except that he's an incredibly wealthy white man, so he has a lot of protections from legal consequences. Now, by the way, let's stop for 1 second. And like occasionally, we're being swept down a river of politics. For a second, let's acknowledge the president's supporters tried to sack the Capitol. In response, one of his chosen defenders, his Secretary of Homeland Security, calls on him to denounce terrorism. He removed him from his position. That should be terrifying for one of several reasons. One is that he's almost certainly going to then replace this guy with someone who doesn't want him to denounce terrorism. And one might wonder, what's the point of replacing him? There's only 13 days left. I don't know. I hope that there's no point. I hope that he doesn't desperately need someone in that position to do something or anything, but we'll see. The other is that hypothetically, a lot of conversations going around DC right now about the invocation potentially of the 25th Amendment. Chad Wolf potentially could have, I don't know about if acting secretaries can vote, because honestly, America's never gotten to this point before. But in theory, he could have been one of those votes to invoke the 25th Amendment. Trump got a pretty good signal of how he might vote from that message and has just removed someone who might be an emergency check on the president if he does something even crazier. We now don't have that. Chad Wolf is going to be out, apparently.
Yeah, and the 25th Amendment never been triggered as far as removing a president. We've triggered portions of it, but not that part. I think it is a viable option if we were talking about a year ago, 2 years ago, but the bureaucracy is just too deep. You literally have to get the vice president, the cabinet, 2/3 of the US Senate. If the president decides to object to it, it creates a whole nother bureaucracy after he objects to his own removal from the White House. I say this, and I told my listeners this on air today. Here's what needs to happen. If they're serious about this guy not doing something even more insane and volatile in the next 13 days, go ahead and impeach him, convict him, hold a one-day trial, remove him. The Constitution literally allows you to do this in one day if you get it together the right way.
Yeah, and a lot are calling for it. Chuck Schumer this morning called for him to be removed from office. Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez wants him removed from office. She also called for Josh Hawley and Ted Cruz to step down based on their continued support for this effort after the terror attack. So we'll see. We'll see.
Yeah. What are corporations going to do at this point? I'm going to start holding corporations responsible. If they make contributions to the Trump campaign, to the Trump PAC, if they make contributions to those who are Trump surrogates and Trump supporters, I'm coming for them in 2021. They are supporting this madness, and they are being, these individuals are being enabled by these same corporate entities.
Yeah, and if they're supporting Ted Cruz and Gosar and all of those, they are paying to continue this undermining, this continued assault on democracy. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.